the difference between a wet raccoon and Donald J. Trump's hair? A wet raccoon doesn't have $7 billion fucking dollars in the bank.
This is a tough business to run for president.
Oh, I know. You're a tough guy, Jeb.
And we need to have a leader that is
real tough.
Honestly, I think Jeb is a very nice person. He's a very nice person, but we need tough people. We need toughness. We need intelligence, and we need tough.
Excuse me, am I allowed to finish?
Go ahead, Mr. Trump.
So,
little of your
again,
own medicine
I put it up.
I know you're trying to build up your energy,
please.
Jeff, but it's not working.
One at a time.
Yeah.
Look.
I feel that by the end of this evening, I'm going to be blamed for everything that's ever happened.
Why not?
It's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Yeah. Because you'd be in jail.
Oh!
You've called women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals. Your Twitter account
only
is
Rosie
several...
O'Donnell.
Turn down for what? Turn down for what? Turn down for what?
Let me just tell you something, and it's very interesting. You're not bringing up anything new. You know, you're acting like you're the great reporter, blah, blah, blah.
There are four immigrants on the whole
Come on, try getting it out. Try getting it out.
I'll get it out.
I mean, I don't know if you're going to put this on television, but you don't even know what you're talking about. Try getting it out.
I never attacked him on his look, and believe me, there's plenty of subject matter right there.
She's supposed to fight all of these different things, and she can't make it 15 feet to her car. Give me a break. Give me a break. Give me a break. She's home resting right now.
You told me on my radio show, the audio and the transcript are out there on YouTube, that you would release your tax returns.
True.
Are you going back on your commitment?
No, I'm not. First of all, very few people listen to your radio show. That's the good news. Let me just tell you. Which happens to be true. Check out the rating.
You might say, you might talk, your politicians all talk, no action. I've been watching it all my life. You are all talk and no action. What I've seen up here, I mean, first of all, this guy's a joke artist and this guy's a liar. You have a combination.
This guy always goes
in the States.
I was a businessman. I got along with Clinton. I got along with everybody. Yeah. That was my job, to get along with people.
But the simple fact is.
Excuse me. One second.
No.
I didn't want to.
The simple fact is, Donald, you cannot take.
More energy tonight. I like that. You've been doing this for 30 years. Why are you just thinking about these solutions right now? For 30 years you've been doing it, and now you're just starting to think of solutions.
Well, actually,
I will bring back jobs. You can't bring back jobs.
Well, once it was finally negotiated and the terms were laid out, I wrote about that in...
You called it the gold standard. You called it the gold standard of trade
and
deals. You said it's the finest deal you've ever seen.
No.
And then you heard what I said about it, and all of a sudden you were again. I didn't think I'd say this, but I'm going to say it, and I hate to say it, but if I win, I am going to instruct my Attorney General to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it, and we're going to have a special prosecutor.
Bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing. You know what that is.
I wanted to challenge you on one of the statements that you made in the tail end of the campaign in the midterms. That this caravan was an invasion. As you know, Mr. President,
I consider it to be an invasion.
As you know, Mr. President, the caravan was not an invasion. It's a group of migrants moving up from Central America towards the border with the U.S.
Thank you for telling me that.
And why did you characterize it as such?
Because I consider it an invasion. You and I have a difference of opinion.
But do you think...
It happened a few days ago.
Triple kill!
They're hundreds of miles away, though. They're hundreds and hundreds of miles away. That's not an invasion.
I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN. All right. And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better. Let me ask you.
Turn down for what? Turn down for what?
One of the worst Secretary of States in the history of the country. She talks about me being dangerous. She's killed hundreds of thousands of people with her stupidity.
505 billion. And by the way, I don't like this mic. Whoever the hell bought this mic system, don't be the son of a bitch to put it in, I'll tell you. These people. No, this mic is terrible.
He hit my hands. Nobody has ever hit my hands. I've never heard of this one. Look at those hands. Are they small hands? And he referred to my hands. If they're small, something else must be small. I guarantee you there's no problem.
Damn, son. You just hit with the wow effect.
I call President Obama and Hillary Clinton the founders of ISIS. They're the founders. In fact, I think we'll give Hillary Clinton the, you know, if you're on a sports team, most valuable player, MVP. You get the MVP award. ISIS will hand her the most valuable player award. Her only competition is Barack Obama.
Let me just, you know, he wants to be a tough guy. A lot of times, you'll have, and it doesn't work very well with
how tough is it to take a times, property from an elderly
talk,
woman?
Let me talk. Quiet.
This is why he's a great politician, because that was one of the greatest non-answers I've ever heard. And that's okay.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried?
That's enough. That's enough.
Mr. President, I was going to ask one of the other folks.
That's enough.
Pardon me, ma'am. I'm Mr. President.
That's enough.
You are an idiot.
You know, she looks just like Hillary Clinton, actually. Is that Hillary? Hillary, is that you? Hillary wants to find out, how do you get these crowds, right? How do you get these crowds? Goodbye, Hillary.
And your father was never considered smart. He was never considered a good senator. He was only a good vice president because he understood how to kiss Barack Obama's ass. Oh! Here in the United States, we are alarmed by the new calls to adopt socialism in our country. America was founded on liberty and independence, and not government coercion, domination, and control. We are born free, and we will stay free.
you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now. Out. He's fired. He's fired.